I want to go check some more.
Love, try not to disturb Joe. He's studying.
Yo, yo, Joe, hey, how's it going?
What's it to you?
It's just a question, man.
It's going fine.
Okay, then. I'll catch you later. Is Joey all right?
Oh, love, he's a bit stressed out with his exams and everything, which is why we've got to be sure we give him all the support we can muster, OK? And that might mean you and Hayley doing some of his chores.
Oh, glad I hurried home.
Well, don't worry, we'll do the same for you when it's your turn.
Yes! I knew you could do it! You rule!
Pick it up, guys.
Come on. Great. And how's me darling little Paul going, eh? Though I bet he's not so little anymore. Oh, we did not! Oh, the little monkey!
What Shakespeare play do you associate with? Baz Luhrmann?
Romeo and Juliet, you gotta know. Romeo and Juliet! Oh, what is Romeo and Juliet?
Oh, that's wonderful, darling. Sorry, love, I can't hear what you're saying. Will, will you turn it down, please?
Hamlet.
Hamlet!
Oh, bad luck.
Where'd you come from?
Love, I'm sorry. Will you turn that runny thing down?
Turn it down, Will. No, it's not Hamlet, okay? It's not Will. Hamlet, turn it down. Turn it down. Turn Will down, Hamlet. No, it isn't Will. Will, turn it down. No, it's not Hamlet, Will.
I think there's a dirty plate in there. Could you go and fetch it for us?
Yep.
Hey, Mastermind. Just coming to pick up this. Are you saving your voice for a special occasion, Joe?
Kenneth Branagh made a film of Hamlet. Laurence Olivier made a film of Hamlet. Mel Gibson made a film of Hamlet, but Baz Luhrmann did not make a film of Hamlet. He did Romeo and Juliet. William Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet.
It's not that important.
Hi.
Hey.
Is Joey in?
Yeah, I hope you haven't come for a fun-packed evening.
Why?
The HSE sort of put Joey into a tailspin. And, you know, I thought he'd breeze straight through it, but he's stressed so much about it, he'll either get 99% or nothing.
Oh, well, it sounds like he needs a break to me.
Yeah, just one word of advice, don't mention Hamlet.
He's not studying Hamlet.
Exactly.
Come in.
It's only me.
Hi.
You don't mind, do you?
No, I'm glad you're here. Sit down.
Actually, Will thought you were a bit stressed.
Well, Will has his own agenda.
Oh, right. Actually, I brought you a CD. I thought you might like to listen to it, relax for half an hour or so.
Well, thank you, Tig. That's so nice of you. I really appreciate this, you know. I really do. Oh, come here.
Sure. Hey, Joey. Good luck with your exam.
How's he going?
Oh, I think he's doing pretty well. He's writing like mad. This is boring, having to go and stand out there doing nothing.
Well, who says we have to?
Shut up!
Hey, Joey, how'd your exam go?
It was all right.
Did you hear about Sam and Hayley?
Yeah.
I mean, it's all bull, but to go off and play basketball. Eileen's still on the warpath about the stereo. She had it checked and the switch is fine.
An horrific road accident has claimed the lives of three people in the state's north. A semi-trailer jackknifed on a notorious bend of the Highway Pacific near Taree Ran and into the oncoming path of a four-wheel drive. In our details o'clock, or the bulletin, at tonight 6. At tonight 6.
Have you heard the latest?
They're coming. They're finally coming.
and her at tonight 6. Claim the lives of three people, Jack and I, ran, and into the oncoming road accident. Or the bulletin in our details box at tonight 6. At tonight 6. At tonight. At tonight 6.
G'day, Fiskies. How's it going?
Good.
Yeah. Can I get you a drink or something?
Yeah, that'd be great. Thanks.
You got it.
What are you making?
Fish.
Hate fish?
I don't care, Will. It's good brain food and Joey needs all the help he can get.
Well, I don't know why I have to suffer all because Joey is.
Well, if you don't like it, then you can fend for yourself.
No, I just don't like those little bone bits.
Well, thank God it's Joey's last exam tomorrow because this has been torture for all of us.
Yeah, well, you don't know what it's like after being in the same room as him.
Well, I saw him earlier. He seemed pretty relaxed.
No, he doesn't know the meaning of the word...
Hello to you too.
Mm-hmm. He's weird. I'm going out. Catch you later.
See ya.
Joey. I was wondering if I could have a word.
Mm-hmm.
As you're probably aware, the Year 12 presentation day is coming up next week, and well, it's customary for a student to make the farewell speech, and I thought you might be the person for the job. Are you interested or?
Yeah.
Right. Good, good. Well, let's organise then.
Just was wondering if we'd like to go and see a movie on Friday night.
Yeah, okay.
Well, don't you want to know which movie it's going to be?
Not particularly.
Joey?
What?
Well, you can at least pretend to be interested.
Oh, why, Tegan? So I can make you happy? What about me?
Okay, I guess you're just stressed about your last exam.
Yeah.
We can go back to your place now. I can help you study.
All right.
Hey, Teeks, did you know that you're all about hanging out with gypsies?
No idea, sorry. See ya. Define gross domestic product.
Tegan, I think that's a little easy.
Come on, you gotta start with the basics.
Gross domestic product is the total economic output of a country. Next. John Maynard Keynes, 1883 to 1946. Educated at Cambridge University, where he later lectured in economics. He's known today as the father of the post-war welfare state. His most important work was A General Theory of Employment, Interest and Money, which he did in 1936. In it, he stated that governments could overcome the problem of unemployment by spending money on large-scale public works.
That is amazing. You're going to blitz this exam, Joey. Hey, do you want a drink?
Yeah, all right.
Okay, well, I'll get them. And no sneaking a look in the book while I'm away, okay? I hope Cordial's okay. There wasn't anything else. Joey?
Right, now you can have whatever you want this morning, all right? My treat.
Is that for all of us or just Joey?
No, all of you.
Oh, shit, pass us the menu.
Oh, Joey, you must be so excited. It's almost all over now.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, this last exam's going to be a piece of cake. You should have heard him last night. He knows everything there is to know about economics.
Economics? He knows everything there is to know about everything.
Oh, I can just see it now. In a couple of years, he'll be running the country. Prime Minister Joey Rainbow.
Yeah, or President Rainbow.
All right then, Professor. What do you fancy? How about some pancakes, eh? Mm.
Yeah, all right.
Joey's exam would have started by now. I hope he's okay.
Yeah, he's pretty quiet this morning.
Oh, he's probably giving that big brain a rest before the big one.
You guys got anything planned for tonight?
Oh, no, he's being really focused. He doesn't want to talk about anything except study.
He doesn't want to talk about anything full stop.
Bet he just rolls up into a ball and dies of exhaustion.
Or his brain will explode.
Actually, I'm hoping that when he finishes his final exam that this new Joey will emerge, you know, relaxed, cool, fun-loving. No, I think you're dreaming. I think you should settle for relaxed. Oh, well, a girl can dream.
Oh, g'day, Dale. How'd your exam go?
You're pretty good.
Oh, that's terrific. You can relax now, eh? So, you've been celebrating with your mates this hour?
Actually, no. I've been working on my speech. I figured that if they're going to ask me to speak on behalf of all the kids in the year, I should at least put put a bit of thought into it.
Ah. Well, no rest for the wicked, eh? What on earth are you doing?
Just working on my speech.
You can be such a nong sometimes, Joey. Haven't you ever heard of an electric light switch? You're going to be blind by the time you're 20.
The computer provides plenty of light, all right?
Now that boy is seriously weird. I mean, he just finishes his major exams, and what's he doing? Sitting in front of a computer screen, working on a flipping speech. I'm telling you, all that study's gone to his brain.
This is cool, isn't it? Just hanging out together, not having to worry about anything.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is like the first time in ages that you haven't had to run off and study on me. I don't know, this year's just been like one big black hole. Oh well, exams are over now. We can finally get on with our lives, or our summer holidays anyway. Guess next year you'll be going off to uni. Still, just have to make the most of the time we have left together.
Have you ever noticed how a song can speak to you without words? It communicates directly with your emotions.
No, I never noticed that.
So, you got your speech all done, Dar?
Yeah, I finished it last night.
Ah, that's good. Well, that takes the pressure off a bit, doesn't it? You can sit back and relax and enjoy your holidays before you start uni.
Yeah, it's gonna be a great holiday, especially since I'm not going to uni.
What?
It's news to me. Why didn't you say anything about this before? Come on, it was only this morning that I was talking about you going off to uni next year.
I hadn't made up my mind.
Oh, right, and now, just all of a sudden, you have?
Yes.
Why?
Because, I don't know, I think uni's overrated. I want to learn from the real world. I don't want to spend the next 4 years in some classroom with a bunch of pretentious know-it-alls who think they've been there and done it all before.
You just hold it right there, sunshine. Those pretentious know-it-alls, as you like to call them, happen to be our doctors and our lawyers and our teachers, you know. They're actually out there doing something with their lives. What are you going to do, eh? If you don't go to uni, you're going to sit around on your bum all day and bludge?
No, I'm going to be a writer.
A writer?
Oh, give me strength. What hat did you pull that one out of?
Irene, that's what I want to do, all right?
Joey, you don't just become a writer. If you were Will, sure, I'd believe you. But the only thing I've ever seen you write is essays.
Doesn't mean I haven't been writing. Actually, I'm working on a novel right now.
Oh, a novel? Oh, well, that should make for interesting reading. So, when do I get to have a geek at it?
What, you don't believe me?
Joey, that's the whole reason that people write stuff, is so that other people can read it, you know?
I know that, okay, but it's not finished yet, and I'd rather finish it before anyone read it.
Well, I guess you won't be needing these anymore.
Don't.
What?
It's just that they're in order.
Sorry, okay. Gosh, these exams really stressed you out, didn't they?
What's that supposed to mean?
Look, you know what I think we should do? We should go away for the weekend. Just you and me. It'll give you a chance to relax and we can spend some time together. You know, so we can develop our relationship. What is wrong with you, Joey, okay? It's like every time I touch you, you pull away. Do I make you sick or something?
It's not you, Tegan, all right? I just can't do this, all right? I'm not ready. I just don't feel like it.
Hey, Joey, what you doing? Joey.
Oh, hi, guys.
Hey, do you want to get...
Actually, I've just finished.
Okay, we'll grab some takeaway then.
No, look, you guys stay. I've got to go home. I've got some stuff to do, okay? I'll see you later.
Bye. See what I mean? It's like I've got some sort of disease or something.
Mm.
He is acting pretty weird. Yeah, he's like that all the time. He's either not listening to me or he's just completely brushing me off. And he's not at all interested in getting to know me better.
And he won't tell you what's wrong?
Well, for ages he said it was the HSC, and I can understand him being a bit stressed out. But, well, he's got no excuse anymore, and he's still avoiding me. Who knows what he wants?
Are you sure you're not putting all this pressure on Joey because you want to prove something to yourself?
Like what?
Well, that you still don't want Colt?
How many times do I have to...
I'm not saying you do. It might seem to Joey like you're trying to speed things up just to reassure him. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Hi.
Hey.
Can I come in?
Yeah.
What's the Sorry, Joey, even Will's song looks cleaner than yours.
Yeah, it is a little messy.
So, why'd you run out on me at the diner like that? What did you have to do?
Oh, just some stuff.
You wanted to get away from me, didn't you?
No.
Come on, Joey, you couldn't get out of the place fast enough. Look, it's fine. I'd just like us to talk about it, that's all. Joey, can you please stop doing that just for 1 second? There's something I would like to say.
What?
Well, I think we're ready. Look, I'm not trying to prove anything to you or to me or to anybody else. I'd just like us to be a bit closer. I'd like us to do things, couple things. We always just get a video and a pizza and, well, I like that, but come on, we're not 14 anymore, are we? Is this making any sense to you? Can you please say something? Joey, do you have an opinion on this, or am I talking to a brick wall? Joey! Thank you very much.
God, what's up now?
Tegan and I have broken up.
Oh, love. God, who isn't having a catastrophe today, eh?
What's wrong with me, Irene?
Love, there's nothing wrong with you. You know, it's just the way things happen. Sometimes they don't always turn out the way you want them to. Hardly ever do, if you ask me. Oh, love. It'll be all right.
It's not going to be all right, okay? It's just not going to be all right.
Oh, love.
Oh. That's it. It's over. That's really hard. Yeah, you're telling me. And it was so embarrassing. What's going on with him? Who knows? Who even cares anymore? No, I'm serious, Tegan. It really sounds like there's something big going on with him. Like what? Well, you're always telling me that you feel more like best friends, right? And if Joey's having troubles with the physical side of things, maybe he's realizing he bats for the other team. Oh, right, after going out with me. Thanks very much. It was just a possibility. No, Joey's problem isn't girls. It's just me.
What's wrong?
Nothing. I was going to ask you the same thing.
I'm fine. Where is everyone?
Well, let's see. Hayley's not here. It'd have to be a reasonably safe bet that wherever Sam is, she is. I didn't almost break my neck falling over Will's skateboard on the way in, so that probably accounts for him. And Chloe's picking up her traveller's checks.
Lucky her.
Well, depends on your definition of luck, Dale. It's not exactly going to be the pleasure trip of a lifetime.
Well, no, but it's going to be an experience.
Anyway, looks like it's just me and you, kiddo. Give you a chance to practice your speech, if you like.
Hey?
Your speech. You know, the one that you're delivering to half of Summer Bay tomorrow?
Ah, yeah. Kind of hard to forget.
Well, you can run it by me later.
Well, actually, I'd rather not, because I've still got a lot of work to do on it.
Lord, save us. Talk about leave things till the last minute.
Don't worry, it'll be ready in time.
Look, love, you know when you told me that you were interested in going into this writing bizarre?
Yeah.
Well, look, I probably said a few things I shouldn't.
Really?
Joey, I am trying to apologise here. It's just that I went through the same thing with Damo, you know, when he dropped out of uni, and I guess I'm just a bit disappointed to see you going down the same path. But hell's bells, where do I get off trying to run people's lives, for God's sakes? I'm turning into Diana. Love, if writing is the thing that you want to do, then you go for it, okay?
Irene, I'm not dropping out. I'm taking steps for the future.
How do you mean?
Success will be my salvation.
Well, I'll keep my fingers crossed for you, Dale.
Irene, if you think that luck has anything to do with success, then let me assure you right now, you are wrong.
Love, it's...
Bad luck is merely an excuse used by people who fail.
It's only a turn of phrase.
Yeah, well, there's plenty of people out there who'd like to see me fail.
Where'd you get an idea like that?
I've been told.
It's damn kids, isn't it? They're just jealous of you, love. Don't you give it a second thought, okay?
To conclude this year's speech day, I have asked one of our Year 12 students, Joey Rainbow, to speak on behalf of the student body.
Thank you, Mr. Fisher. The playwright George Bernard Shaw once said, "My education was only interrupted by my schooling." Well, I'm not sure everyone who has attended Summer Bay High would agree with that. My own time here got off to a pretty bad start when I went to see Mr. Fisher, trying to tell him that his methods were dictatorial. Well, nothing seems to have changed. Mr. Fisher in particular has taught us the value of tradition. While many other schools have been faddishly changing their approach to meet the needs of the 21st century, he has very wisely stuck to the methods that have served us so well in the past. And whilst other schools have allowed the students a say in the running of the school, he has clung to his belief that to do so would be denying his own responsibility to decide what is best for his students. My education, was it interrupted by my schooling? Well, no, it didn't happen in my case. I hope you all feel the same way. Thank you.
You were playing at out there, Joey. No wonder you didn't want me to listen to the damn thing before you did it. You know, I went along there today thinking it was going to be one of the proudest moments of my life. Well, you certainly managed to turn that one around, didn't you?
I'm terribly sorry if I spoiled it for you, Irene.
You embarrassed the living daylights out of me, Joey. But I'm telling you one thing, that is nothing compared to the embarrassment you should be feeling for yourself.
I didn't have any choice.
Oh, what a load of piffle. Mate, if you have got grievances to air, there is a time and a place, okay? You hurt and embarrassed a lot of people out there today. People who have helped you, but people who've believed in you. I mean, I'm surprised you didn't have a go at me. I was waiting for it, I can tell you.
You'll never understand.
That's right. You go off and you hide in your room while I make the apologies. But you may as well stay there, mate, because it'll be a long time before anyone around here wants to see your ugly mug again.
Anyone for another coffee?
No, thanks, love. Actually, I might take a rain check. I was going to get stuck into some spring cleaning while Joey was away, you know, one less under my feet.
Oh, where is he?
Oh, he's gone away for a couple of days camping with Aaron.
Aaron?
Yeah, he's back from the States for a week, and then he's off somewhere else, apparently.
Oh, Joey would be glad to have his company.
Yeah, and it'll be good for him to get away for a couple of days, too. He still hasn't settled down since the HSC.
Oh, how'd he go?
A TER of 92, do you mind?
Way to go, Joey.
Man, you should have seen the breakfasts in the States. They were like mega huge.
Yeah?
Yeah. We're in this place, where was it? Pasadena or something. Anyway, I asked for some breakfast, right? They bring out this bucket-sized bowl full of cornflakes with about 2 litres of milk. Unbelievable.
Yeah, that sounds like a real big breakfast.
Oh, sorry, man. Here's me going on about America. You haven't even told me about the HSC.
Well, there's not much to tell, really. It was no big deal.
No big deal? Maybe not for you. Just a 92%. I'm just glad I didn't have to face it. What?
Did you hear something?
Right, you can do your room now.
I thought you were in charge of the vacuuming.
Not your room.
All right, mister. What is the big idea?
Huh?
Hiding this stuff in your room and not doing a very good job of it either.
What is it, Irene?
Oh, don't play the innocent with me, Will. I didn't come down in the last shower. It's marijuana, dope, pot, whatever it is you kids call it these days.
Yeah, well, it's not mine.
Me, don't look at me.
Man, that cult is a real unit. Right, we're up on stage, and he just totally forgets the words to this song. So he starts up with, Mary had a little lamb and Humpty Dumpty, and no one noticed, man. Who says the words matter in pop songs, eh?
Yeah, not me.
I mean, I know that there are people around who say that it's not addictive and that it's no worse than a beer or two, but I'm telling you now, I am not having it under my roof. Do you understand me? It's illegal.
Irene.
I mean, I'm sure half of these smack and crack fiends start off with a whiff of something like this. You guys are far too young to be boozing and smoking funny cigarettes. I mean, just think what it's doing to your bodies. Not to mention the fact that you could wind up in the clink.
Warren, I think we're getting off the point. The point is that we both don't smoke anything.
Yeah, thanks for the lecture, but I'm clean.
Yeah, and remember all that stuff when Gypsy bought me the stuff? I wasn't into it then. Why should I be into it now?
All right, well, answer me one thing. If it's not yours, what the hell is it doing in your room?
It's not just my room, Irene.
Well, that's that little lot taken care of. Nobody's going to be smoking that in a hurry, I can tell you.
What'd you do with it?
Oh, it's in the bin, mixed with some old tea leaves and rotten old veggies.
Good.
Listen, love, I've been thinking, Will was pretty convincing when he said the stuff wasn't his, you know.
Well, he's hardly going to admit to it, is he?
No, I mean, really convincing. He sold me anyway, and so did Haley.
Oh, I see. Well, I assume that you don't think it's mine. So that only leaves...
Exactly. Who else could it be?
No, come on, there must be a mistake. I mean, Joey.
Yeah, well, I don't like to think that it's him either, love, but you've got to admit he's hardly been himself the last couple of months.
Yeah, but that's just the HSC.
You reckon? I came down here the other night. It was about 2:30. I thought I heard a noise. And here's Joey with three saucepans full of mushroom soup on the go at once. Said he fancied a snack. Now you tell me, it's the HSC making him do it.
Yeah, it does sound like munchies.
And what?
Smoking pot makes you really hungry.
Really?
There's no place like the scrub, eh, mate?
Yeah.
You know, I'd love to live in L.A. or New York or somewhere. Somehow, I reckon I'd always end up back here.
Yeah.
So what are you going to do? You going to move away to uni or what?
Oh, yeah.
Joey, what is the matter, man? I'm doing all the talking here.
Yeah, right.
Chloe, love, have you had a chance to talk to James about, you know?
Oh, no, I haven't.
Right, well, me and Chloe were talking earlier on and we were wondering if you could maybe help us out a bit.
Yeah, sure, if I can.
It's a bit difficult, actually.
Irene thinks, and she's probably right, that Joey's smoking dope.
I see.
And I think it's gone way past the experimental stage. I was wondering if you could find out what we could do about it, maybe get him into counselling or something.
Well, if I were you, I'd talk to him first and see what he has to say.
Oh, don't worry. I'll be doing that too. But I want to nip this in the bud before it gets out of hand. Joey's got way too much going for him. I don't want to see him wasted.
Mayfair, say. Two houses. That means everything you got, thank you very much.
Stupid game.
My turn. So, where's Joey? I thought he'd be here by now.
Maybe he knows how much trouble he's in and he's staying away.
Trouble? Yeah, Irene found dope in his room and the fingers pointed at him. You're kidding. I thought Joey was the straightest guy in the world.
Yep, so did we.
Here they are. G'day, fellas.
Hi.
Hey, Joey.
Gee, you two look like you had a bit of a rough night.
Yeah, you could say that. Look, Irene, I think there's something wrong with Joey.
What do you mean?
Well, he started smoking dope. I asked him what he thought he was doing, you know, like, he used to be so anti-drugs, and he said it helps him with the voices in his head.
What?
I think Joey's got a serious problem, Irene.
He looks like the Night of the Living Dead. If that's what the smoking the stuff does to you, I'm steering well clear.
Well, do you think he's been doing it for long?
Oh, no, you wouldn't say. I don't reckon he was like this when I left.
Well, what about you? Has he said anything to you?
Me?
Well, you do share a room with him.
No, hasn't said anything to me.
Aaron told me about you smoking the dope.
Mm-hmm.
Mind you, it didn't come as too much of a surprise. I found a bag of it while you were away. I'd like an explanation.
Don't have one.
Joey, why? I thought you were smarter than this.
What's being smart got to do with it?
Love, if you're worried about something, you know that drugs aren't the answer, don't you?
Well, Irene, that depends on what the question is.
Look, I want you to promise me that you will never bring drugs into my house ever again. Do you understand me? I won't have it. You only get one warning, mate. Love, look, if you're in trouble or you've got problems, you don't have to face them by yourself. I'm here to help you, love. You only have to ask.
Irene, I don't need any help.
Are you sure about
it? I said I was fine.
Guess you couldn't say it in front of Irene, but did you know that Joey was on drugs?
No, I just thought he was cracking up, man.
Joey's always been so anti-drugs. I just don't get why he suddenly changed his mind about the whole thing.
Neither, man.
I mean, most people, they get into drugs because their friends do it, and or their life's so terrible that they have to try and find an escape somehow, but Joey just doesn't fit those categories.
Yeah, but the HSE is pretty stressful.
Well, I don't see what Joey's got to stress about. I mean, he was doing really well at school.
Do you know what I reckon it is? Joey's such a perfectionist that he doesn't know how to wind down. He always puts himself under so much pressure to be the best he can all the time that it just got too much for him.
Yes, that's right. The student's name is Joey Rainbow. Yeah, well, the problem is, Joey is one of my best students, but the results on the sheet are simply abysmal. I mean, there's got to be some mistake, surely.
James, this is Aaron, Joey's friend he went camping with. Aaron,
yeah,
James.
Aaron, so have you spoken to him about the...
About the dope? Yeah, at length. No one seems to be able to get through to him, though. Even Aaron's worried about him.
Yeah. Look, I'd never seen him touch the stuff. And yesterday he pulls out a joint and offers me some. Totally not Joey.
Tell him what else happened.
Well, most of the day, you know, he was pretty quiet, even withdrawn. And then in the afternoon, he just went totally psycho and started chucking stuff around.
You know, maybe the dope's just the tip of the iceberg. God, I never thought I'd hear myself say this in a million years, but there's every chance that Joey could be taking something stronger than marijuana.
Joey, I know how seductive it can seem. It's like it's going to solve all your problems, but they don't. They just create new ones.
I don't have any problems.
Okay. Well, if you need a friend to talk to, you know where to find me.
Look, man, I'm off. I'll catch you around before I go, okay? Mate, I had to tell her. I'll see you later.
Hello.
Oh, good day, Don. Come on in.
Thanks. Actually, I was wondering if I could have a word with Joey.
Oh, look, he's asleep at the moment. He had a big one last night. Is there something I can help you with?
Well, yes, possibly. I've just been looking over the HSC results, and I was really surprised when I came to Joey's.
Surprised?
Well, yeah. I mean, what went wrong? I mean, do you have any idea? Or...
I have no idea what you're talking about, Don. As far as I know, nothing went wrong.
Well, something must have gone wrong for him to get such low marks.
He got a TER of 92.
He did?
Absolutely.
Look, I'm sorry, Irene. I'll ask the department to check up again. I told them there must be some mistake.
Yeah, there must be.
It was so weird going to America, especially New York. I mean, you see all these things like the Statue of Liberty and the Empire State Building so many times on television, it just spins you out when you finally get to see them close up.
Hey, you know, I'd always fancied seeing the Grand Canyon. Who knows, eh? Maybe one of these days.
Yeah, maybe.
You know, Arth was a bit worried you weren't looking after yourself, but you look pretty healthy to me. What are you, meat in your bones?
This ain't meat, Alf, it's some fat. American food, it's a killer. I'll tell you what, if there's one thing I miss more than anything, it's Alf's home cooking.
You're right.
I'm very worried about you, love.
Don't worry about me, Irene, okay? I can take care of myself.
Joey, I want to help you. That's what I'm here for.
There's some things that you can't help me with. I know the drugs are bad.
What haven't you told me, Joey? What else are you taking?
That's not important, okay? What's important is that I've stopped. Things have been a little unusual for me lately.
that doesn't matter, okay? The thing is, I've decided that I'm going to get healthy, so no more drugs.
Well, I'm glad to hear that.
Good. So you've got nothing to worry about, okay? I'm going to be as fit as a fiddle and ready for love.
I said, do you want to catch a movie?